Okay, so let us start. Let us start now, right? So, what is geometry? Who can tell me what do you mean by geometry? Is there anyone who can tell me what do you mean by geometry? What is geometry? Who can tell me?
Sir, can I tell?
Yes, yes. Yes.
The part of mathematics that deals with such subjects as points, lines, planes, and space is called geometry.
Yes, geometry is that part of mathematics. It deals with point, line, ray, straight line, right? Plane, curved plane. We say plane, and there is also curved surface. There is plane surface, there is curved surface, right? And also points. And also triangle and many such objects which are called geometric objects. If you deal with all the things, that part of mathematics is called geometry. Now it is clear to you? Very good. So let us start with one thing. Suppose you take a book. The best important thing, take a book, right? This part is flat, this part is also flat. Yes or no? So what can we say about this? What is this? This is a plane. This is a plane. Think of this part of a phone. What is this? This is a screen of a phone. It is a plane. Yes or no? Backside is also plane. So plane means evenly spreaded area. Area which is spreaded evenly, that is called plane. Okay, how it is? Suppose this is a book. If you take a book like this, then the upper part is called plane. This is called plane, right? Okay, now what is curved surface? You can tell me what is curved surface. This is plane, it's fine, but what is curved surface? You can tell me curved surface. What do you mean by curve? Curve means which is not plane. Suppose take a ball. Suppose take a ball, right? What is this? What is this? What is this? This is part. When it touches the ball, it is not with a regular shape like the spoon. It is somehow bending. It is bending. And this is called what? Curve. This is called curve. And the surface area is called curve surface. It is called curve surface. Now clear? So we have got both plane surface and curve surface. This is what is mainly we distinguish with ourselves. Okay, think of a door. Sanchita, tell me what is a door? Plane surface to curve surface?
Plane surface.
Yes. Okay, it's a plane surface. What about a ball? It's a curved surface. Very good. So we had discussed other things in our earlier classes. What were they? One is we discussed one thing, that is
point.
First, most essential important part of our discussion is number one, and that number one is, I'm going to write some things that you can understand. What is this? Point.
Is a mark of a location.
What is a point? Who can define this? Point is just.
Yes. Can I define?
Yes, yes. Point. Just a dot. Yes? Yes?
A point is a mark of position.
Yes. Point is a mark of position or location, we can say, as a position or location, we can also say, right? And point is generally used to show certain thing, to display certain thing, to mark a thing, we use a point. And dear students, let me tell you that point has no proper definition. We can understand it, but we cannot define it properly, right? So point is a mark of location, this much you can say. And we can also say, this is a circle having zero radius. This radius is zero, we can say like that also. Okay, so point. Now, second thing we know is that line. What's a line?
Line is a line segment extend indefinitely.
What do you mean by line? Line is something which we also know. Line means, this is called line. Yes or no? What is line?
Line is a line segment that indefinite extend
inward direction. Anyone? Okay, let me speak. This line. Line is very simple. Line is a line segment extended indefinitely in both directions. What do you mean by this? Line is a line segment which is extended indefinitely. Means there is no end to it. There is no starting point. There is no ending point of a line. It just goes, moves, and moves in opposite directions. In opposite directions, right? This is called a line. Okay. Now, third, we can say ray. What do you mean by ray?
Sir, a line which only goes in one direction.
Yes, it means it can move at one direction. There is an ending point, or you can say there is a starting point for this, and there is no other point. Only one point is there. This is a ray. Then comes our line segment. What do you mean by line segment?
A line segment is a straight line that has a beginning and an end.
Okay, you can say like this. Otherwise, you can also say, suppose there is we take two destinations, A and B. Suppose A is Sanchita's home, B is Tanisha's home, right? Sanchita and Tanisha, they're very good friends, and they want to travel one friend to another friend's home. So on the way, this is Asu's home, this is Suryakant's home, this is someone's home, this is someone's home, this is someone's home, this is other friend's home. So if Sanchita wants from A, she wants to B, she can go like this. She can touch this friend, she can touch this friend, she can touch this friend, she can come here. Also, she can follow this route, this route, this route, and this route also. She can move to a medicine store, then she can go like this also. She can go to a chicken center, then she can also go here. Yes or no? These all are called distance. These are called distance.
Distance. But
the shortest distance. Always use this word. The shortened distance between two points is called line segment. Now clear?
Yes, sir.
And straight, shortest and straight distance between two points is called a line segment. Now clear? Suppose this is C and D. This is C and this is D. Then what we have to, where we can find it? We cannot say this is a line segment. We cannot say this is a line segment. We cannot say this is a line segment. This is a line segment. Wrong. What is right? One thing is right, and that is from here to here, exactly. It means from C to D. This is called line segment. Now clear? All of you?
Yes, sir.
Very good. So this is all about point, line, ray, and line segment. Okay, let us move to next page. Let us move to our next page. There we'll discuss some more. Okay. Now, a line is something. This is a line, right? Okay. How many points are there in a line? How many points are there in a line? Yes, is a line segment. Let us take A, B. We can also tell it is L1. Just tell me, how many points are there in a line? Who can answer?
Sir,
Indefinite points. There is one ending point, or there is starting point, and there is ending point, starting point. But between that, there are numerous, thousands, lakhs, unnumberable. Matlab, it is all infinite, right? Indefinite. Matlab, we can't count it. So many points are there over here, right? Okay. So when this is a line segment comes, okay, now, and the friend of yours comes, she also have a line. Now, this line is CD.
Intersecting line.
This is CD. This is CD. Then, look, these two lines has, line segment says, one common point. What is the common point? That is E. Is it clear? That is E. E is the common point between two. Matlab, E can be, we can say E is on AB. We can also say E is on CD also. Yes or no? This is called common point. This is called common point. This is called a common point. So if we find one common point between two lines, then we call they're intersecting each other or they're crossing with each other. For that mathematical terms, we can use that is intersecting. Intersecting with each other. So we can say intersecting lines. Okay? Or you can say intersecting line segments. So they're intersecting with each other when they have only one common point. Okay, can you tell me how many common lines they can have? Suppose you have two lines. If they intersect with each other, will they have only one point or maybe more than one point where they can intersect?
One point.
Yes, there is always only one point where they can intersect, because intersection happens when they cross with each other. Otherwise, they will become only one point means they can intersect. Yes, right? Okay, very good. Now, what we'll do is that from one point, how many lines can be drawn? Okay, suppose I have this point. From this point, how many lines can I draw? Yes, can you answer me? By a single point, how many lines can grow, can go, or can pass? Or from one point, how many lines can start? Are you here? Infinite. सबको देखो यहां से मैं निकलूंगा एक यस और एक यस और एक और एक यस और नो इज देयर एनी लिमिट दैट आई कैन ड्रॉ ओनली फाइव ओनली सिक्स ओनली सेवन लाइक दैट
नो सर
सो हाउ मेनी लाइंस कैन बी ड्रॉन थ्रू अ सिंगल पॉइंट फ्रॉम अ सिंगल पॉइंट आई कैन ड्रॉ न्यूमरस मतलब इनफिनाइट नंबर ऑफ points, infinite number of lines. Now clear? All of you clear?
Yes, sir.
We can draw, we can write like this. Make a note from your note. Note my note now. We can draw a number of lines or rays, we can say, or line segments. From a point. Now clear? Matlab kya hai? From one point we can draw as many as possible rays, lines, and also line segments. It is not finite. The take point se ek hi line niklega. And many and aur ek cheez bhi isme aata hai. One more thing you can say. Suppose this is a line. How many lines can cross through this? It is also indefinite. Dekho, suppose ek hai. Next, I will go to another line. Sorry. Okay. Now I can draw this one also. I can draw another line through this point. I can draw another line through this point. I can draw another line through this point. So, how many lines can be drawn through this point? Indefinite or infinite. Now, clear? Is it clear to you people?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts? Okay, very good. Now, there are lines which intersect with each other. If the lines don't intersect with each other, then what you can say? Okay, if these lines pass through a single point, hum usko kya bolenge? What the term we will use for them? I have told you earlier. Suppose many lines, these are lines, okay? They're not, these are lines, straight lines. If more than two lines cross through a single point, then all of them is called concurrent lines. So, kya bolenge hum? Concurrent lines. Is it clear? What do you mean concurrent lines? Concurrent line means more than two lines, if they cross through a single point, if they pass through a single point, like three lines, four lines, five lines, more than 10 lines, they all are called concurrent lines. Clear? Like this is called intersecting lines. जैसे यहाँ पर हम intersecting line बोलते हैं, इसको बोलते हैं concurrent lines. If more than two, यहाँ पे two है तो we say concurrent intersecting lines. But there more than two are there. They're crossing, they're passing through only single point. That's why we say this is concurrent lines. Now clear? Got it? Okay, very good. Now let's go to another page. Okay, now we have seen lines cross each other. If lines don't cross each other, then what we'll call them? Now there are lines.
Parallel lines.
Which never cross each other. Yes, they are called
parallel lines.
Parallel lines. Now clear? What do you mean parallel lines? Parallel lines, yes, are nothing, but those lines which never cross each other. Which never cross each other. Like this is a line.
Train
button. Yes. The best example is track of train. Yes or no? You see now. These are two lines, two straight lines. These are two straight lines. Now, can you see it? Okay. Now, you see train lines. Do they cross each other? No. The distance between them is always the same, and most important, they never cross each other, never intersect each other. They never intersect each other. Now clear? Never intersect each other. Now it is clear to you people? These are covalent. Yes, sir. And do you know why they don't intersect? The distance between them, distance means perpendicular distance. Yes, yes, no. Perpendicular distance between them is always same. Which distance is same?
Perpendicular.
Perpendicular. Yes, this symbol is stands for perpendicular. Okay. Perpendicular distance. The perpendicular distance between two lines always same. That's why they don't intersect with each other. Now clear about this? Are you ready? Okay. Getting? So, let me ask some questions to you right now. Let me ask some questions to you right now. Okay. 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 Now, from this point, we came to angles. We came to angles, right? From point, what you learned to the point, then straight line, line segment. From this, we got a new topic that is called angle. That is called angles. Okay, very good. Now, who can tell me how many types of angles are there?
Sir, can I tell?
Yes, one by one. One.
Acute
angle. Very good. Acute angle.
Right angle.
Then.
Obtuse angle.
Sir, right angle.
Very good. Then acute.
Sir, obtuse angle.
Right. Then obtuse angle.
Reflex then, angle.
Reflex. Okay. Straight then reflex. Sorry. Just a minute. Yes. We will go in order. We will go in order. Right.
The straight angle.
Then yes. Straight angle. Then
reflex
angle.
Complete.
Then called complete angle.
Complete
angle. Right. These all are the angles. I think there is no need to explain this. You people know it better. Okay. Still, for a confirmation, we will just discuss about it. Okay. Let me. What do you mean by acute angle?
The angle which is start
the measurement of an angle. If you say like this, if the measurement of an angle is between 0 to 90 degree, the value is 0 degree to 90 degree, then this angle is called acute angle. Very good. What can be right angle?
The measurement of angle
sir,
is 90 degree.
Yes. Right, yes, the measurement of an angle, if the measurement of an angle is 90 degree, then that is called, it is exactly 90 degree, then that's called right angle. Okay, what is an obtuse angle?
An angle whose measure is greater than 90
degrees. Yes, take 180 hai, so it is between 90 to 180. The measurement, if the measurement of an angle is between 90 to 180 degree, then this is called an obtuse angle. What's a straight angle? What's a straight angle? The
measure is 180 degrees called straight angle.
Yes, very good. Exactly here, but it is 180 degree. How much is it? 180 degree. It is exactly 180 degree. Then what's the reflex angle?
An angle whose measure is 180 degree but less than 360
degrees. Yes. Reflex
angle.
Dekho yahan par. Idhar se nahi. Idhar se jayenge hum. From this place. Its value is between 180 degree to 360 degree. Then what's the complete angle? Complete degree matlab?
Angle whose measure is 360 degree is called an complete angle.
Yes. 360 degree is called an complete angle. Now clear about this?
Yes, sir.
Very, very good. By using these angles, we can do many such things. Okay, let us know what's an angle first. How can we form an angle? An angle can be formed by two what? An angle can be formed by either two straight lines or also by two line segments or also by two rays, right? So it doesn't matter how much is the long, how much is the length of the line. It depends on what is the angular moment they do. It depends on the angular moment, angular measurement between the two things. It can extend to any extent. It can extend to any extent. Doesn't matter. What matters? The angular distance between these two is called angle. Just so suppose there is one line here. Look, what is an angle? First, just make it. This one line, this other line. This line is L1. Wait, wait. This line is L1. We can say, take this line L2. These are two lines. They're separated from each other. But if we make them come together, now you can see there's a distance between them. Here there's a distance. But if they both have only one starting point, dono ka starting point hai ke? Yes or no? Then they're called angles. If they're different, at different places, they are not angles. But when they intersect with each other, or you can say both have only starting point, having only one starting point, then the between angular measure between them is called an angle. Now it is clear? Yeah. So an angle has two arms. How many arms? Two arms.
Yeah.
Either maybe two straight lines, maybe two rays, or maybe two, what you can say? Maybe two line segments, maybe two line segments. Now clear? So this is called an angle. This is called an angle, right? Okay, very good. So after this, we will learn about curve. We will learn about curve. Okay, what's a curve? Who can say what is a curve to me?
There are four types of curves.
What's a curve? Look, this is a straight line. This is a straight line, right? But what about this? What's a straight line? What's a curve? This is a straight line. Straight line. But this is a curve. This is a curve. Now clear? So, can we explain a curve?
There are four types of, there are many types of curve. Example is open curve, closed curve, simple open curve.
Okay, look. From straight line and curve, this is a small difference. Look, suppose this is a point A, this is a point Z. Okay? Now what we will do, if we want to move from here to there, we want to move with the straight line, the shortest distance, then this is called straight line. This is called straight line. But if you go aimlessly, hamare paas bahut time hai, we have got petrol, full tank, full petrol in our car, we just want to travel. Then kya karenge hum? Pura din hamare paas hai. Pura chutti hai yaar. Chalo, aaj khelna hai, kudna hai, kuch bhi karo. No studies. Now what you will do? Will you go quickly? No. You will find different paths. क्या करो तुम चलो होटल चलते हैं we'll go to hotel. Then आओगे तुम बोलोगे नहीं पार्क चलो this is hotel. Now this is park. Now this is you go to another restaurant. Now we'll go to another place. Then you go to your home. Yes or no? So this is if you move aimlessly, if you move our pencil aimlessly, there is no aim. Then you get a curve. Now clear? What's curve? Curve means if we take a pencil on a paper and move aimlessly, kuch direction nahi, kuch distance, destination nahi, just aimless movement, then that is called curve. Now clear? Any doubts?
No.
Very good. So curve is very easy to understand. Yes or no? Okay, can you give an example of curve using those things which is at your home? Ghar mein jo cheez hai, from that, give an example of curve.
Clock.
Anyone? Baba, give me curve. Okay, you see, ads of this mobile phone. Kuch mobile phone ka ads straight hota hai, but mera mobile phone hai, iska ads curve hai. Hai ki nahi? Yes or no? You can see water bottle. Versus cap. Cap ka this part jo hai na, upper part, that is plain. But this part kya hota hai? This part is a curve. Yes or no? The bottle itself is a curve. Bottle itself is a curve. Yes? Yes.
Spring.
Yes.
Spring.
The round spring is a curve. Very good. Is an example of curve. Yes. Okay. You can say hair. I don't have hair. Don't worry. I'm blessed with God. But those people who has hair, is the hair straight?
Yeah.
It is always curve. उसको क्या बोलते हैं? Curling hair बोलते हैं किस-किस लोगों को? Many curves are there. Yes or no? Like that? Any more examples?
Yes.
Would you like to give any more examples? ट्राई टू फाइंड एग्जाम्पल्स फ्रॉम यूर डे टू डे एक्टिविटीज. ओके, घर में जो होता है ना तुम्हारा, आई मीन मे बी सम स्पेक्टेकल, सम स्पेक्टेकल्स आर ऑल्सो राउंडेड, मीन्स दे आर कर्व्ड लाइक दैट, यस एंड नो. देन यू कैन सी सम ऑफ योर बुक्स, पर बुक्स होता है एंड द एज पर द बुक समटाइम्स इट गेट बिकम कर्व्ड, स्ट्रेट नहीं होता है, दैट बिकम्स कर्व कुछ डायरीज में कुछ बुक्स में. सो देर आर सो मेनी. ओके, दिस इज की, यू सी, कैन यू सी दिस की, कैन यू सी दिस की, दिस इज ए की रिंग. व्हाट इज द की रिंग? की रिंग इज ए कर्व वन. की का जो अपर पार्ट है दैट इज ऑल्सो कर्व वन, यस नो. सो दिस आर ऑल कर्व्ड कर्व. दिस इज ए विक्स विद मी इनहेलर, इट्स ऑल्सो कर्व वन, यस नो. सो सो मेनी थिंग्स विच इज कर्व. ओके, जनरली कर्व इज ऑल्सो, curve is also different types, but as far as your yoga class is concerned, we will read about four types of curves. How many types of curves are there?
Four types
of curves are there.
Open curve, closed curve.
Four types of
simple closed curve.
Curves are there.
Well, one is closed curve and another is open curve.
Go sequence. First say open curve.
Open curve.
Then second is
closed curve.
Third is simple closed curve.
Closed open curve.
Then the fourth one is simple closed curve.
Simple closed curve.
Okay, these are the types of curves which are available as per your studies concerned. Okay, now what is simple curve? Who can give an example to me?
What's a simple curve?
A curve which does not cross itself. Suppose you see, what is this? तुम देखो कुछ बुक में आर्ट होता है, like this, in this book, there may be some arts. कुछ कभी आर्ट होता है, देखो कभी कभी कुछ ब्यूटी, कुछ ब्यूटी प्रोडक्ट रहते हैं ना, उसमें कुछ आर्ट होता है, जैसे है कि नहीं, शर्ट में कुछ, कपड़े में कुछ डिजाइन होते हैं, मम्मी की साड़ी में देखो कुछ डिजाइन होते हैं, लाइक दिस होता है ना. दीज आर कॉल्ड सिंपल कर्व्स, दीज आर कॉल्ड सिंपल कर्व्स. ओके, now clear?
Sir, in snake and ladder, snakes are also in simple curve.
Yes, next case होता है, ऐसे ऊपर जाओगे 99 के पास एक snake होगा, क्यों लेकिन आगे तुम्हें तीन में लेके आ जाएगा. Yes or no? This is called simple curve. Okay, now we can say what is an open curve. What is an open curve? Open curve means what? An open curve whose starting point is different from end point. Starting point is different from end point, right? So simple curve क्या होता है basically, which does not cross each other. Simple curve का definition होता है that does not cross each other. That doesn't
cross
each other. This is the first definition of simple curve. Simple means that doesn't cross each other. Now open curve means they have got two different points. There is one starting point and there is one ending point. Okay, then that is called an open curve. Then that's called an open curve. Jaise ki main bolunga aise, there is a starting point, there is an ending point, right? Now clear? Ek curve aisa ho jayega, the starting point, there is open point, matlab it is not closed. Closed means what? Think of a circle. Can you think of a circle? Can you think of a circle? Ellipse, anda. Who eats anda? Egg, kun kun kha raha hai?
Yeah.
Who is eating anda? Egg. What happens? This is closed. Very good. Eat it. So what is this? Is there, can you find a starting point, ending point? No. Agar you pick one point, that is its starting point, that's also its ending point. Getting? So this both are called, these are called closed. Closed means when they don't have starting point and end point. Now what is simple closed step? सिंपल में क्या है, दैट डोंट क्रॉस ईच अदर, दैट डज नॉट क्रॉस ईच अदर, एंड क्लोज मींस क्लोज हो गया. सपोज आई एम मेकिंग दिस वन, लुक दे आर क्रॉसिंग ईच अदर, सो दिस इज नॉट ए सिंपल क्लोज कर्व, इट्स अ क्लोज कर्व बट इज नॉट सिंपल वन. सिंपल मतलब व्हिच डज नॉट क्रॉस ईच अदर. नाउ क्लियर, दिस इज अ सिंपल क्लोज, this is a simple close, but this cannot be simple close, this cannot be simple close because they are crossing each other. Now clear, are you clear about this?
Yes sir.
Simple means that does not cross each other. Open means they are having both points, one ending point, one close, one starting point, one ending point. Close means they are closed, there is no way to get in, boundary ho gaya charo taraf se. If you cut, that is the starting point, that is the ending point. But simple close means that doesn't cross each other and they are closed, then this is called simple closed. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes sir.
Okay, very good. Now let us go to some other points. We have discussed point, plane, angle, curve. Now an angle is what? If you have two sides, then it's an angle. Okay, if you have three sides, then what we call it?
Triangle.
Okay. If I got more than two sides, suppose I got more than two sides, what do you call it?
Square or rectangle.
Okay. If I got more than that also, suppose I got
hexagon or anything else.
I got more than that. What is this? You can say. Yes. Carry on.
Sir, I don't know.
You don't know? This also, I can draw this one also. Look, try means what? Teen ke liye try. Let me write a clue for you. Three ke liye? Three ke liye try. Four ke liye? Quadri. Q-U-A-D-R-I. Quadri. Five ke liye? Penta. Six ke liye? Hexa, hexa, okay. Seven is called hepta. Eight is called octa. Eight is called
octa.
Nine is called nano.
Nine
are yes. It is called nano. Okay. 10 is called deca. 10 is called deca. Now clear about this? One is called
what is type of name?
Yes, from here we will go there. Right. One is called mono. Two is called di. Look, write this. Mono, di, tri, quadri, penta, hexa, hepta, octa, nano, deca. If you remember this, in future you will get it. Okay, triangle, why? You see, triangle. Now clear? Triangle. Teen angle is iska naam ho gaya. Triangle. Now clear? Okay. Ab yahan par four hai, toh kya bolenge? Quadrilateral. Usko kya bolenge hum?
Quadrilateral.
Q-U-A-D-R-I-L-A-T-E-R-A-L. Quadrilateral. This is known as? Quadrilateral. Matlab char side hoga. Maybe it's a rectangle, maybe it's, you know, a square, maybe it's a diamond, maybe cube, but maybe. Char hoga to quadri ho jayega. This five, kya bole usko? Pentagon.
Pentagon.
Okay, it is called pentagon. Agar six hua to?
Hexagon.
Very good, hexagon. Seven ho gaya to? Octagon. Eight ho gaya to octagon. Nine ho gaya to nanogon. Ten ho gaya to decagon. Now clear? Now clear now? This is what
yes, sir.
Is called, if you have how many sides, accordingly the name is given to that. Now clear? Okay.
Sir, can you send a picture about this?
Okay, I will upload the video. I will upload the video so that you can take the screenshot of this one. Right? I'm recording this. I will upload this video so that you people can take this and others can also see it. Okay, now let us go to this one. Okay, we see a triangle. First, we will discuss about a triangle and quadrilateral. You see, there is a triangle. We always see triangle. Okay, who can tell me what are the constituents of a triangle? what constitutes triangle or what are the components of a triangle, matlab kisko leke triangle hua hai aur triangle ke andar kya hai, what are the components of a triangle, what are the components of triangle, what is this
vectors,
sides, very important, these are sides, number one. What is number two? What is this? What is this? And what is this?
Vectors.
Angles. These are angles. And what is this? This one.
Vectors.
Vertex. It's not vectors, it's vertex. What do you mean by this? Or you can
vertex.
Say top point. Instead of saying top points, we call it vertex.
Vertex.
Now clear? Besides this, is there anything else in the triangle?
No.
Yes, there is something which we don't see. Iske andar kuch hai jo hume dikhta nahi hai.
Triangle.
White paper.
Dekho, suppose this is the middle point. Ab kya hoga? Joint hoga ye?
Line.
Kya bolenge usko? If a line which connects the midpoint of one side and the vertex of another one, what do you call it?
Angle.
Median.
Median line.
पढ़ा था या नहीं पढ़ा
है?
ओके मे बी इन क्लास ओके डोंट वरी सो बस फॉर योर कन्वीनियंस जान लो मीडियन बोलते हैं उसको मिडिल पॉइंट जोड़ करेगा मीडियन उसको बोलते हैं राइट
ओके सर
एंड जब 90 डिग्री हो जाएगा ना उसको क्या बोलेंगे परपेंडिकुलर इफ इट कम्स टू विथ 90 डिग्री इफ देयर इज अ ट्रायंगल व्हिच इज राइट हैंड ट्रायंगल उसको क्या बोलेंगे हम परपेंडिकुलर ओके Now it is clear to you people. So basically, a triangle constitutes of these three things: sides, angles, and vertex. Clear? Very good. Like that, if we go to a quadrilateral. Now let us see what is there in a quadrilateral. Kya kya hai iske andar? This is a quadrilateral. Now you can tell me what are there? A, B, C, D. Let us name this. So what is there within this? Iskandar, kya hai? Who can say me what are this? Now this is one is angle. One angle. Very good. Then two sides. Very good.
Three vertex.
It's also there.
Third diagonal.
Yes, very important thing that diagonal. One thing is present that is called diagonal. That means we can connect opposite points. We can connect opposite points. AC. And we can also connect B and D.
Huh.
These are called diagonals. These are called
diagonals.
Now it is clear to you. Angle,
yes, sir.
Vertex, then sides and diagonals. Right? Okay. Within side, we can also find another subset. This is a side, this is a side. What do you call these two sides, AB and BC? I told you, if two sides are just nearby each other, the two form an angle. उसको क्या बोलेंगे? What you call to these two sides?
AB.
Adjacent sides. उसको क्या बोलते हैं?
Adjacent.
Don't remember? देखो, if you don't repeat, you don't remember. I have told you, adjacent sides. What do you call it?
Adjacent sides.
What are the adjacent sides? AB. And BC, both are adjacent sides. Now clear? Are you clear? So we've got sides, angles, adjacent sides, vertices, and diagonals. Now clear? रह गया? Vertex का जो plural होता है ना, vertices हो जाएगा वो. V-E-R-T-I-C-S. Vertex is one. This is the top point is called vertex, and there are four vertices that is called vertices. It's called vertices. Now are you clear about this? What is A triangle, what yes, is sir. Rectangle, all the things. So this is called polygon. Poly means more than one. Gon means sides. देखो इसका more than two sides है. More than two sides के हैं. इसलिए इसको बोलते हैं polygon. That's why we call it polygon. Now it is clear to you people? Okay.
Yes. Sir.
Okay. Now within this we can find one more thing. That is, look, this is a point. Suppose I take a point Z. I take a point Z. Hello.
Sir, very well. I think it is not visible.
Okay, where the screen? Just wait. I can't see the screen also. Okay.
But we can see, sir.
Yes, now it is come. Right? It is come now. Okay. Now suppose this is a point. G. Where is the point? Who can say where the point lies? This is a point F.
In the middle of.
And this is a point Q. Who can tell me where is G, where is F, and where is Q? Where is G, where is F, and where is Q? Who can tell me? Quick, quick. Do it quick, fast. Where is G?
Interior. Interior.
Interior of quadrilateral. Interior. If it is here, then also you can enter a triangle. Yes. If it is within the boundaries of any polygon, that is called interior. Isko kya bolte hain?
Interior.
Anshuman is good. His answer is correctly. Now, where is F? Who can say?
On the quadrilateral.
We can say on the quadrilateral. Isko bolte hain? On the quadrilateral. And where is Q?
Exterior.
Exterior of rectangle. This is called exterior of quadrilateral. Now it is clear. Same thing applicable for triangle also. You can apply the same thing for triangles also. Right? Is it clear? If a point is here, you say it is interior. If a point is here, you can say on the triangle. If it is here, you can say it is exterior of the triangle. Now it is clear to you people? Good? Okay. Very good. Now, if you go for quadrilateral, we have two types of quadrilaterals. How many types of quadrilaterals are there? Two types of quadrilaterals. One is convex and another is concave. Concave quadrilateral and there is convex quadrilateral. It is about quadrilaterals. Okay. Quadrilaterals. Quadri means what? Four, I've said you. If someone has four sides, this is called a quadrilateral. Uska char side hoga to quadrilateral hoga. Quadrilaterals are of two types. What are they? What is concave? What is convex? Do you know anyone who can tell me? Concave means two diagonals. If it's two diagonals, what is diagonal? Diagonal which is joining opposite points. Two diagonals are interior of that are interior of the quadrilateral, then they're called concave. If it is not interior, that's called convex. Let us draw a diagram for you so that you it can be easy for you to remember. Okay, you see this one. Okay, this is a quadrilateral. Right? How can I draw it? I'm drawing one. This is one what? Diagonal. This is another diagonal. Now, where are the diagonals? All diagonals are inside the quadrilateral. Clear? So this is called concave. They are interior. That's why this is called concave quadrilateral. But if I draw another quadrilateral like this, you see, I'm going to draw another quadrilateral. Okay. Okay. Clear? Clear? Are you clear about this?
Yes, sir.
Now let us name it. Maybe it is A, B, C, D. Now let us draw diagonals. Okay. So what are the opposite points? A, C is the opposite points. Let us join them. Now what are the opposite points? B, D are the opposite points. Let us join them. Then can you see where is B, D? AC is inside the quadrilateral. Yes or no? AC is inside the quadrilateral. This is quadrilateral. To quadrilateral ke andar raha gaya wo. It's fine. But where is BD? Is ke andar hai? Ye hai hamara quadrilateral. But where is BD? Is BD interior of quadrilateral ABCD?
No.
No. In that case, we say ABCD is a convex quadrilateral. Now clear? What is concave quadrilateral?
Yes,
concave
sir.
Quadrilateral is the quadrilateral where two diagonals remain interior part or interior of the quadrilateral. But what's a convex quadrilateral? Convex quadrilateral is the quadrilateral where the diagonals are not an interior part of the quadrilateral. Is it clear to you? Is it clear? Should you understand properly? Okay, so this is all about this quadrilateral, triangle, and all the things, right? Okay. Now, shall I give some questions to you? Because you know we have studied a lot. Or shall I?
Sir, can I tell a topic?
Okay, so let me do one thing. This is all about this. Once you finish this, we will go to circle also, right? Once this is finished, we will go to circle, right?